anytime you're working out of a small shop, you almost have to like clean and reevaluate your space every week. At least that's what I do. Because the evaluation of your space changes as your projects change. Some things are more important sometimes, and then the next week something else may take priority. So kind of have to move and shift and clean and hide and tuck and throw away stuff. So that's kind of what I'm doing this morning. I wanted to mess with the Bibbster just a little bit, and then I'm gonna work on the Gray Goose. Try to get some stuff done on that thing. So light, I barely touch the ground. Everybody wants to know how. Brick by brick, I put them in the ground. Walk like I built, walk like I built this. Do it for my people, family business. And everybody wants to know how. Take a good look, you are now witness. If I catch something on fire, somebody call the fire department, please. She's definitely a little more transparent. Took the doors off and cut some of the floor pan out. I'm not gonna use that floor pan anyway. I'm gonna make a completely new one, so it's all gotta go. Anyway, I'm not gonna fool with the Bibbster anymore. I'm gonna get on the Goose. I really wanna get that thing done before I even work on this car here, so. One of the things that still needs to be done in this car is seam sealed everything. There's a lot of cracks and crevices and parts where I've cut the floor to run bars through, and there's a tight, you know, it's a pretty tight gap, but I need to seam seal it all before the carpet goes back in. I'm gonna have to vacuum it again because there's just crap everywhere where they did the roof, but that's the plan. Vacuum, some seam sealer, let it dry overnight, carpet's gonna go back in it, and I gotta mock up some stuff for the seat belts still, so the seats will have to come in and out. I mean, I got one bracket here, but I gotta make a passenger side bracket. I got belts on the way, so I'll get those mounted. Gotta do some wiring, but I can do that with carpet in it, so. I think it's pretty close for the interior to go back in for the final time. I mean, hopefully it won't have to come back out again. Alright, so got the inside pretty well sealed up. Still got a couple of things I gotta do. I still gotta fabricate seatbelt brackets, and I gotta tie the upper control arms into the actual cage itself. So still gotta do those two things. I can actually probably put the carpet in there. I'm not too afraid of burning it with the TIG welder. So I don't know, maybe I might get that thing fit back in there. I'm gonna go ahead and pull out the rear end right now. While I'm under, I'll kind of show you some of the modifications I made in order to bring the springs in a little bit. I did a mini tub on it, and I actually showed it in some videos in the past, but I didn't really show it very well. I basically moved the factory tubs in 1.5 inches, moved the upper spring perch in 1.5 inches, and that's just to clear some a little bit bigger tires. Plus, I can set the rear tires in a little bit and just kind of give it a better stance and a better look. Took a long time just for that little bit of 1.5 inches. You can't really tell though, it looks like factory on the inside and under the wheel wells. So, you know, goes back to that thing I always say, it's the little things that really make a big difference. When you see this car, it's gonna look factory tubs, factory suspension, but when you see it sitting there, they're gonna be like, man, he's tucking them 10-inch tires up under there really well compared to everything else that's out there that's factory. So, you know, it's the little things. Anyway, let's get this thing pulled out. It's got a, let me see, I think I've got a 456 gear in it, 488. It's got a really low gear in it. The class that I used to run was an all motor class, and you needed a lot of gear. For what I'm gonna do with it now, as far as just driving it on the street and maybe some top speed stuff, I'm definitely gonna have to change the gear. We're gonna go like a 327 or a 355. Got the Power Glide too, so I don't have overdrive anymore. And I'm gonna need that extra gear just to get down the road without just making her scream. So rear end's out, we're gonna clean it up, change the gear, and I'll show you the suspension. Go ahead and show you what I was talking about when I was talking about moving the factory tubs in a little bit. Basically, it's all factory sheet metal. I just basically cut it out and then, you know, brought this section in 1.5 inches and then put a piece of filler in there. So the actual shock tower brace and the spring perch and all that stuff was just moved in 1.5 inches, and I just cut it down here, and then once I brought it in, I just re-welded everything. And the factory plastics will actually come down and still cover all this up, so nobody will ever know. And I'll show you underneath too, the difference that it made down there. Made a hell of a mess today, that's for sure. I don't think I've got this dirty in a long time. I'm gonna attempt to get some lighting under here so you can kind of see what it was I was talking about. So there's the perch, and you can see it's been moved in 1.5 inches, and then I just kind of contoured that frame rail match the spring. Now it's still a little bit raw. I'm gonna have to go in there and clean it up and coat it. I'll just, you know, I'll undercoat the whole thing, but
turned out really well.
All right, guys, I think that's it for this week. Hope you enjoyed it. That was a getting dirty video, but if I don't post another video this week, I will see you guys Friday. Measure my growth by the season. Limits don't exist if you don't give them.